Mondays with Misa. Misa John, come here. Say hi, sit. We're riding with Scott Mydock today. Vet Moto from Arizona. Talks so much smack mountain biking, but then he hikes. You ready to hike with the old man, huh? There's no hiking today, you said?
I'm gonna try not to, but I ain't promising anything.
I was talking to Scrubby. I can't take you down Diablo.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate that.
We're 1/4 of the way to the top.
I know. I remember this. I think I stopped here last time.
So you drive out from Arizona to do our races?
I do. Phoenix.
Phoenix, Arizona. Yeah. How are the tracks out there?
ACP is awesome. We got a new guy on him. We only have two
tracks.
Doesn't
Bobby White own ACP?
Yeah.
Yeah, Bobby's cool.
Yeah, he's awesome. So they know what they're doing. They got it together. Canyon. Canyon's kind of world famous, right?
That's the place that Scrubby goes and rides with you, right?
Yeah, so it's closed.
Oh, why?
It's state trust land. They wouldn't renew the lease. They're going to put a development in there.
Oh, that's gay.
So it's gone. So we have another one in Casa Grande called Motoland.
Uh-huh.
It's kind of okay, but a new guy bought it. So he's been fixing it up.
Yeah.
So his goal is to get it, you know.
Lisa, she's in the grass. Come here. You're going to get bit by a rattlesnake. Hey. Hey. You don't have tear-offs? So
Motoland has been getting better and better.
Uh-huh.
He's only had it for maybe 6 months. So his goal is to get it good like ACP.
Yeah, sick.
Then that's it. We'll still only have two tracks.
Mm.
There's a brand new one they're building just past Quartzsite, like the border.
Yeah.
So the people at the river, Juju, right? People at Havasu, they'll have a track pretty close to go to. It's still 2 hours from Phoenix. So if I'm going to drive from 2 hours, I might as well just keep going
to Huya.
Yeah. You know.
Yep. So I imagine all the mountain biking there is flat.
In Phoenix?
It's totally flat since you see a hill and you quiver.
No, that's not true. Actually, you'd be surprised the climbs we have. It's just
I'm talking about the downhills.
Oh yeah. So I'm a cross country weenie, right? By trade. So
what?
All this...
But you have a trail bike.
Yeah, that's why I got it, so I could learn how to ride this stuff that you ride. Right? Because I'm not into racing cross country anymore, so I want to have fun. I've always loved downhill and everything. I just never really did it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's a new experience.
Whoa. Holy crap.
Dude, oh man. I'm good. No, I gotta put my seat down. Yeah, I was way up too high. All right, I'm okay now.
Yeah, you won't use your seat at all.
Whew, yeah.
Did she go behind you or is she coming?
She was good. She was waiting for me, I think, because she knew I was in trouble. Dang, how do you even take these turns, bro? Ah. The first hike and shoot. Damn it.
Yeah, bro, that's way too hard for me, I think. Damn it.
Get straight down, bro.
Oh, dude.
Holy crap.
Hey, that's nothing.
Oh, no, don't tell me that.
I'll tell you that's the worst part of this trail, though.
Okay.
That's the hardest part.
That was pretty tough. I had to walk to shoot most of it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Footprints?
Dude.
Funny.
Shit, I don't even know if I can make it down that. Dude, that's so steep. Doesn't look like it, but it is. Gotta make one shoot without getting off. Finally. Finally. No, that one ain't bad. Compared to up there, that was easy. A lot of it's just mental. I got an arm pump.
Right here.
I don't think I ever got an arm pump on a mountain bike.
Right here, make sure you go on the right side of the track when you're going down.
Okay. Right side. Right side. Gotta listen to Swap or he might die out here. I made it. Damn. Instead of spinal, it's all mental.
Okay, we're at Vegland Incorporated, to see Chicken Matiasevich. Mataz. So we have a set of limited edition Fox gear to give him and do a video with. So we're in Chicken's trophy room at Vegland. This is a Jack Finn bike. Did you know that midget goes pretty fast on a mountain bike?
Yeah, he rides a lot, yeah.
Yeah. Where do you keep your current bike, at home?
Home, yeah.
Yeah? And you broke your neck?
Yeah.
How about that picture of that thing open back up? Why did it open back up?
It just blew apart. I don't know.
The stitches came
out? I was up north and thing just My daughter went to remove the bandage. She's like, Dad, I can see your spine. I'm like,
oh, shit.
So I went to the hospital, and then they tried to commit me there. But I flew up there on a private jet. So I'm going home. I'll be home in 40 minutes.
Yeah.
You need surgery. You're not going nowhere. Well, here's my doctor. Call my doctor. So they called my doctor, and I went to the airport, jumped on the jet, and came home real quick. And had to do surgery all over again.
Really?
Yeah. Major.
So what did they do? Did they fuse stuff or cage it?
Yeah, put two rods in there, and then bolts, and fused four vertebrae together. So
are you going to be all good now?
Yeah, I'll have full mobility, and everything's fine.
And what happened? You went over the bars at Glen Helen or something?
Sort of swapped out over the bars, yeah. Just high speed.
So there's no paralysis or anything?
No. Supposed to be.
Thank God.
Supposed to be good, yeah. So.
Where's, here's the good stuff.
The good ones, I think, still up at my parents' house. But
yeah?
I said, I don't have anything motocross at my house. So.
Nothing? Just your current shit.
It's just my bike at my house, yeah. But,
dude.
So this was, I actually told my...
What is that?
Looks like maybe my brother.
Is it a mini? No, it's not. It's not you?
That's me, yeah.
32?
Yeah.
Is that like an ultra cross or something?
Yeah, that looks like a... probably ultra crossing, yeah. Or the Mickey Thompson thing, whatever that was.
Yeah, that was ultra cross.
Okay. These are forced air coolers for strawberries and everything that when they come in from the field, they suck all that heat out of the pallet, of the product.
Oh, yeah.
Bring it down to a cooler degree.
Man, you guys got a lot of ginger.
Yeah.
It's all those damn Asians.
Yeah.
Use it for the chicks.
Sucho juice drink. Sucho.
Oh, okay.
That. This is just a box room, basically. Uh-huh. All boxes. And,
how many, I don't even know the terms, but like how many chains do you distribute to?
We're nationwide.
Nationwide?
Yeah.
Oh wow, it's not just SoCal.
No, it goes all the way up to Maine.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you have to eat a lot of salad as a kid?
No, you know what's funny is like my dad, my mom always shops at the grocery store for everything. We never take nothing home. You got all this shit. Sundays we're usually closed, shut down, and we'll build a big old go-kart track all through here.
Green onions from a Japanese farm.
Huh?
There's a Japanese farm name on that box.
Yeah. And all these coolers, because it's fresh produce, by the end of the day, all this shit will be empty.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So it just comes in the morning, you get it early in the morning, and then the trucks come, and it'll be all pretty much emptied out by the end of the day.
Wow. How did COVID-19 affect you guys?
It didn't really... Actually, we got sort of probably more busier because more people were at home eating than out at restaurants. We do the chain stores, you know?
Yeah.
So not as many people are out at restaurants, obviously, so we got busier.
Sweet potatoes, dates.
So this is...
Shelbyville, where Dillon's, Columbus.
Clackamas, Oregon.
Shit. We do a lot for Kroger, which Kroger owns a bunch of shit.
Coconuts.
Strawberries off the 5 freeway over in Irvine?
Yeah.
That, all those fields? Uh-huh. That's all that right there.
Okay, from here. I saw some watermelons back there. I was going to film them for Scrubby.
This is our fresh cut.
Oh, yeah. So that's for like when you buy them cut up in
cut
a
up in the clear container.
I know, right? Beets.
Beets. You got all that. We got the bottles and the powder beet stuff.
Ooh. Beets are supposed to be good for
your blood.
Blood.
Yeah.
Oxygen.
Oxygen.
Cholesterol.
Yeah.
Johnny O got me on the beet juice.
On the beets?
Yeah.
You want some beets?
No, I hate beets.
Why do you do it taste like shit?
Damn, we got everything.
Shit everywhere, huh?
Yeah. What time does stuff start showing up in the mornings?
6.
6 a.m.
Yeah.
What time does it stop leaving?
Until they're done.
Really?
10 at night.
Oh, wow. Dude. Do you know which vegetables are in every room?
Which vegetables are in
every room? Like if I said I want a box of green beans, you'd know which room to go to?
Yeah,
oh.
It'd be that one. That cool one.
Yeah.
So
oh, really?
34 degrees.
Okay.
He's running at like 38.
Potatoes? Take a look at this. Oh, is this the one that was on your head in that picture?
No, it was not
that one, but one like that. Look at the rocker.
Yeah, you're right
at
where the boxes are. We
could
bring that to where. Oh, yeah, that
would work. Giant, huh? So, Chicken, when you were running a mullet in the 90s.
The mullet? It's coming back. Mullets are coming back.
Yeah, they are coming back. But when you were running the mullet in the 90s, were you just like, yeah, my hair is sick?
It was the sickest. Not sick, the sickest. Yeah, I think it's coming back, I heard. You met my brother, Jimmy?
John, how are you, bud?
You did. Hi.
How are you guys doing?
Good, good.
Chase.
Chase, nice to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you, man.
No, I'm out of here.
Where are you going?
Pizza.
You ever been to Fuoco?
Uh-oh.
Dude.
We good?
Yeah. We're at San Clemente.
Oh, okay.
It's Wednesday. Dude, what is with the weather here?
It was raining through Temecula on my way here.
Really?
Yeah.
Dude.
Yeah. We have MTV flow with us.
Yeah, I usually just drive because...
My hand came off. My hand came off. Yeah, I'm good. That was weird.
Did it
take
it? Huh? Did a
tree take
it?
No, it's my hand's kind of like when I crashed it down the dirt. I gotta go get a neck adjustment.
Good?
Yeah. Oh shit. Old man shoulders right there. Chain come off?
Fucking chain.
Oh shit!
You okay?
Yeah. It's that kind of day, dude.
Okay, we're at Paris for RM Army boot camp day. Luke's over. Scrub daddy. Purple bike.
Oh, whoa! When'd you get the purple helmet?
Ahead, I was saving it just for this day.
Oh, match the bike. Did you have it before you got the bike color?
No.
After.
Yeah.
That helmet's too big. It's a large.
No, he made it a medium.
Oh, okay. Man. Sergeant. Sergeant Mayor.
Hey, Felix, what's going on here at Parrish?
Yo, we have the RM Army boot camp for all of our RMZ owners. And we're just having a Riders Appreciation Day here in Paris.
And so you have the Twisted T HTP Suzuki team here.
Yep.
Chisholm, and new recruit for the summer is Fred Norn.
Yep. We're going to announce that tomorrow at the press conference over there in Paula. So yeah. It's going to be pretty exciting that we're going to have Freddie back on Suzuki.
Yeah. So. This is the second boot camp, right?
Yeah, the first one was in Tulare.
Tulare.
Yeah.
And I heard that there's some RM 250 two-strokes showing up there.
They are. They're actually going to be a couple coming today, too.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice. So, I mean, we talked about it at the beginning of Supercross season, but now that season's over, what impact did Ken Robson racing a Suzuki have on Suzuki popularity and sales?
I think it just flipped the script on everything and just made it, I think we've become irrelevant again, yeah. And which is great. You know, the image of Suzuki in off-road is, I think, in more positive light now, and I'm excited. You know, it's, it makes everybody want to ride a Suzuki, even though we don't have electric start. And, you know, Kickstart Kenny, it's a culture thing, you know. He did his own little drop of his merch during Kickstart Kenny, which is awesome. And I'm excited with what's in store in the next couple months and next year.
Nice. So how many Suzuki riders are signed up to show up today?
There's over 50 people signed up today.
Nice.
And just Suzuki owners in general. So
cool.
It's going to be cool to see all the yellow on the track today.
Yeah. Well, our guy Scrap Daddy's out there, so it's black and yellow.
Yeah. And purple, right?
Yeah. What is your rank in the RAM Army?
I don't know.
Sergeant?
I guess. I don't know. You tell me.
I think Kenny would be the general.
Yeah.
So maybe it's
Sergeant.
Got Cupine Racing out here. All three of the kids. All three of them, 416.
Hey, he says he's on a diet, salad and chicken only.
That's it, baby.
Dude, did you see a scale?
How much did it weigh?
170.
Four. Yeah, it's all right.
Hey, I saw you sweet talking to the lady just now.
Nah, that's the homegirl, man.
He's trying to work the white sheet over there.
You know? Hey, you want to know why he was trying to impress? He got two diamonds on today.
You know, I had to come off for the Suzuki.
Two
know?
Of them.
I had to show him. I can bling, bling.
Yeah, that's Jolly two blings.
Yeah, I told him. They say, we want you over here. I said, nah, can't come over there yet.
It is how I walk down. You got a boom.
Yeah, this is how I walk down the Broadway.
Is this how you go down, you wear roller skates and go down the street?
Yep. That's when you walk down Martin Luther King Boulevard.
Yeah. LA's going to rock better.
Thank you. Thursday morning before press day. And trying to get a ride in before heading to Paula Casino and Fox Raceway for the start of the Nationals. Ready, Mies? Look at this guy sneaking in. Excuse me, sir. Can I see your credentials, sir?
Oh, I got it right here.
Do I got this thing on right?
What?
Do I got it on right?
Oh.
Is it on?
Yeah.
boots?
What?
Whose boots?
From Ferres. Oh. In Ferres, yeah.
Okay. And he's making you run?
Yeah.
How far do you have to run?
Just a bit.
Just a bit?
Yeah. Okay. Get the boots a bit softer.
Is it hard to run in boots?
Yeah.
Doesn't look easy.
Yeah.
You better get to running.
You follow me?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Thanks for those tires again, by the way.
You're welcome. How was Havasu? The weekend off.
Mellow.
Yeah?
Well, we had a boat problem as soon as we got there.
Oh, boat problems. Our boats are temperamental things, aren't
they? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No mountain. No. Boat's an acronym.
No. What is it acronym
Break
for?
Break out another thousand.
Ah, that's a good one, yeah?
No, the from the factory, the boot popped off of the throttle body from the intercooler because it had a supercharger.
Mm-hmm.
And just like, moved. But did a little online forum search and
yeah, you can find anything on YouTube. Dude.
Absolutely.
What do you think of AC's barbed wire?
Yeah, I like it. I'm gonna go get a free tattoo. I heard Fox giving out barbed wire
tattoos. Free tattoo. You're gonna do on the base of your wiener?
I don't know if they have enough barbed wire.
They need a whole spool.
Yeah.
You come out with a price yet?
What's that?
You come out with the advertising rates yet?
No. I'm still working on it. We did record episode 2 yesterday.
I know. When's it go live?
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
Friday.
I told him I want to buy a reed.
I'm still working on, it's pretty difficult to like structure a show.
No, no structure is the best.
Yeah, kind of just two guys having a conversation is the best way to go about it.
Yeah, and then take a break in the middle for the ad.
What's that?
You take a break in the middle for the advertising, you know?
I could read off a couple lines for you, Swapmoto Live.
Yeah. So what do you think of the barbed wire? I think it's sick.
I like it. Cool red gear. I normally, it's a cool colorway.
Are you wearing all red or are you going to do purple at some time?
I'd love purple. That'd be awesome.
Purple's good. Jeff Matiasevich, 1992.
Chicken, baby.
The chicken.
Chicken.
Cashler. What's that?
Good?
Are you trying to turn off? Are you doing secret shit?
Yeah, basically as soon as I start working, you gotta get the
fuck out. So, no surprises? Huh?
Another day in the office, man.
Yeah, another day in the office?
Go to work.
Did he, first session time stood, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah. He's a, not to discredit maybe anybody else, but he's such a gamer. He wants to know that type of stuff. So once he realized, and they did close the gap there at the end a little bit faster, which is the flip point to the way that he likes to operate on stuff like that. So, he was aware of kind of where everything sat, and did a decent lap. So he had some mistakes and a guy down in the back with a red cross bike or something. And that was his best time, which is a little bit off first practice, but he was still like P4 and that one, or P3, whatever it was, right?
Yeah.
But P1 overall from the first practice. So.
Mm-hmm.
Messing with the bike a little bit, fine-tuning, and everybody knows this, when the gate drops, it's when the points are paid, so all this stuff is just for bantering and media and messing around.
So he's coming in pretty fresh, right? Because there's no long Supercross season to be recovering from.
Yes, sir, that was unfortunate for him, 2021 Supercross champion, West Coast, and then not able to defend because of an injury. So what that did is it pointed him out of the 250 class, so left in a really gray area in our sport, so can't race Supercross 250 class, can only race 450 Supercross, but hasn't knocked off the 250 championship, been in the run a couple years now, everybody knows that, so like I say, just trying to, the team tried to do the best they could with him, and at that point it was, hey, you'll go race, this is in 22, you'll go race outdoors this year, and then outdoors in 23, and we'll keep you fresh all Supercross season, and if it comes up to ride a 450, you will. So that came up, and thanks to Bobby Reagan and guys at Yamaha and everybody, they made it happen.
Did you enjoy staying off the road a little bit? Did you have to go to every round, or did you only go to ones with him?
I went to the only ones that he raced.
Yeah.
But we do this stuff to race, man.
Huh?
We do this stuff to race.
Yeah.
So for me, when I'm over it, I'll get off the road permanently. I'm not that guy. You might catch me on a day where I'm like, fuck, man, travel will get you,
But
that's why you do it, is to come out on the weekend and kind of see where you sit, work your butt off. But the high fives and handshakes at the test track or practice track only get you really so far. This is what pays the bills, and it's nice to see where we're at,
Yeah.
So like I say, for him, it's he's got a lot of preparation, he's sitting in a very good spot, and but you never know, that's why we go racing. So
yeah.
hopefully for, you know, hope for a good start, right? We have greats this year, it's a new thing.
Mm-hmm.
Try to execute there and man, just solid laps. If he leaves here, to me, yes, position does matter to an extent, but if he leaves here and feels like he rode well and the bike performed well, mm-hmm. the position to me isn't as big of a deal. You know,
yeah.
Where I get bummed is if he comes off and he has an issue, you know, with the motorcycle, how it was handling, how it was reacting, things of that nature. That's where I'm like, man, that's on me. You know,
yeah.
That's on us.
Yeah.
So, all in all for me, yeah, I'd love to snag off some really good results, but as long as the kid pulls off the track and has a smile on his face, we're winning. We're good.
Cool. So, Austin, tell me about your wild media day.
Yeah, so in riding back from practice, there was a blind corner over there and ended up getting hit by a truck. Nobody's fault, but weird incident. A little sore today. My mechanic's on the couch right now recovering, but we're out here racing and going to make the best of it.
Wow, because initially I had heard like you guys both had broken legs.
Yeah, when I first happened, my leg hurt really bad, but I just had like bad deep bruising in like my ankle and my leg.
Yeah.
But luckily I had boots on, so I mean, if I didn't, it probably wouldn't be here today.
Yeah. How's your mechanic?
He's good. He got 24 staples in his leg and cracked kneecap.
Okay.
So
wow.
He's on the mend now, and yeah, we're just doing what we can.
So how'd qualifying go for you?
It was all right. Rode pretty tense, but we made it in, got 34th.
Nice.
Just hopefully get out racing and get that intensity back and
cool.
Get it going.
Hey, who made that airbox scoot?
3DP. Yeah.
Is it like a 3D printing? Like?
Yeah, I'm not really sure how he makes it, but yeah, he hooked me up with that thing. It's got my name and number on it. So yeah, it's a pretty cool thing.
Can you tell it's on there?
What's that?
Can you tell on the bike?
Yeah, no, I mean, it definitely helps a little bit with the breathing through the airbox and stuff. Yeah, I enjoy that thing. It's awesome.
Nice. Hey, good luck today.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I'm trying to get 25. I probably will sound for 12. If you
qualify. We're scrubbed out
here. We're in the ARA pits, deep in the heart of the privateer ghetto. Where'd he end up? Is he 20th?
Like 21st.
21st?
He went a little bit faster, dude. But everyone else did too.
Yeah, I was pumped when he was, 15th in the first one, but then they combined. Yeah. And
yeah, we got people just dropping out parts. I just showed up this year. I called him. He's like, don't know who did it.
Huh. Like, they need to be dropping off
clutches.
Clutches and clutch lever.
Brakes.
Clutch levers with bearings.
Yeah. Even drop off two fresh wrists, that'd be pretty good.
Yeah. So this is practice bike, turns out?
Yeah. Honestly, the only thing that's wrong with it is this 12 on the other side super stripped out, but.
Oh.
Yeah, it looks better in better shape than the race bike.
So he's running the engine mounts out from.
Yeah, we just made like tiny changes to the suspension that press day, and everything's been money.
Nice. So this shock is valve for the swing arm or not?
I don't know if it's valid for the swing arm, but like all we had to do was go like two stiffer on it.
Yeah.
We got three stiffer and we went two faster. Mm-hmm. And then we went two faster on the forks. And he's like, dude, don't even touch it.
Nice.
Tell me about barbed wire.
Barbed wire? I don't really know what that is, but I guess it's like a replica a long time ago. I think the red on the green.
1992, before you were born.
Yeah, I know, I think it looks really cool.
Yeah.
I love the game, yeah.
Do you have butt bats today? What is it?
I think it was High Danger.
High Danger?
I guess, yeah. These are not mine, but yeah, the Fox guys.
High Danger. Like Abu Nai?
I think, yeah, I don't know.
What does that mean?
High Danger. Stay out of it. kind of stuff.
Oh, your boss is open now.
What?
More.
No, same.
Okay. Time is everything.
And waits for no one.
Waits for no one. And then dog.
My dog.
You have that dog?
Yeah.
You have dog here?
I have a mini pincher in Japan.
Okay, and then Swallow.
You learned good it all luck.
What is Swallow for?
Good luck.
Good luck?
I put it in here so like before the race,
yeah.
I'll like bring my jerseys up so I can see it makes me feel better.
And then what are you on now?
Just for my grandma.
Grandpa's birthday?
Man, you're turning American.
I know.
I know. You're not living on the edge, you're taking up too much.
Well, you're gonna go a sleeve like Lucas.
Yeah.
See, what? Let me see your sleeve.
Oh, Ingmaster.
Yeah.
Worst tattoos ever.
I know, but like, okay, so that's.
Don't
dos muertos?
Yeah.
Huh? How about his? How about this guy?
Yeah, go. Him and Jet, they're the Ingmasters now.
Yeah, Ingmasters.
Is your dog a boy or girl?
Boy.
Oh.
Go and check it. Go check out Jet's
girl dog. If it was a girl dog, you could look at his bird and go, swallow, bitch, swallow. How are you feeling about your guys' pro debut?
I'm excited. The last 5-6 weeks have been, he's really stepped it up, so it's been cool to see and, you know, to see where he's came from. I mean, I've been with him now for just over 2 years. And for this to be here now and then to see the progress he's made, it's been cool to be part of.
I was a little nervous on the first lap of press day.
I think all of us were.
Get through press day.
Yes, we got to make it through. The goal is to go have fun. He's been working, so go enjoy it. It's been a long time coming.
Is Jet healthy right now?
Yeah.
100%?
Since Texas, like I said, that's been about 6 weeks now. He's made a lot of progress. Speed's improved. I feel like his motos are pretty solid, but we don't know until we know. So today's the time to tell where we're at.
Cool. As his mindset. Nervous or is he just stoked and ready to go?
He's matured a lot the last couple years since we started, and it's been cool to see him kind of turn things around for himself. And we're here and we're looking forward to the summer.
What's up, guys? You remember me?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Who do you got today?
What?
Who's gonna win the 250 class and who's gonna win the 450 class?
Yeah.
Who do you got? Jet?
Yeah,
Jet for the 450s?
What about for 250? For the 250.
Ah, okay. What about you?
Jet.
Jet?
Yeah.
What about Hunter? What about 250 class?
Hunter.
Hunter? Oh, you guys are both Team Jet and Hunter. The Lawrence brothers. So, what do you think? If your dad was 10 years younger and in his prime, could he take down the Lawrence brothers?
Yeah,
I think so, huh? Your dad was badass. I asked your boys who's gonna win, and they're just all in the Lawrence bandwagon.
Jet and Hunter. Big Lawrence fans, but also Brax is a big Chase fan too.
Yeah. But you know,
when it was separated, when Jet was still lights, and then Chase was the 450 guy. So now we are in a rough patch here, you know.
Yeah.
Caught between a hard place and a rock. Yeah. Now we gotta go, both the riders to win.
So the good news is, I said, hey, if your dad was 10 years younger in his prime, would he wax him? They're all, yeah.
Well, that's good. At least they know that, right?
Yeah, they know, right?
At least they know that. YouTube has filled them in.
That's good. The outside line master. So, how's being a big podcaster?
It's
going
good.
Really well, yeah?
Yeah, no, I think it is going. It's going good. We have, you know, some great partners involved.
Mm-hmm.
NBC being one of them.
Yeah.
And a great platform just to start. And myself and Ricky, every Monday we film. You know, record and Aaron at NBC, he puts it all up, gets it all ready, gets the production side done, and it's been fun. I've kind of talked about doing it for a while, or people have told me to do it because they want to hear what I have
to say. Dude, when you were in the box a few times, you did great.
I don't mind it. I don't know if I'd want to be going every single weekend to call stuff, you know, but a few step-ins here and there are always fun, you know, it keeps me busy and just something different.
Mm-hmm. Who you got today? Are you with your kids?
Who do I have today? I mean, obviously, if you just go off the lap times, right?
So. Justin Cooper.
But also 450, like Jet being 2.5 already.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Paul is always a funny race. Really definitely comes down to a start because it tends to get a little bit one line, so.
Dude, look at that roach behind you.
Oh, yeah. I'm into it.
That's going to be a good tan, right?
So yeah, we'll see. I mean, it should be some good racing. Outdoors is always, you know, I'm sure these guys, a lot of the guys are all burnt out, but from a fan, I guess from my standpoint, outdoors is always special to start out, you know. It's
yeah.
Just different than Supercross.
Whoa.
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 Alright, when are we pedaling?
Soon.
Yeah?
Soon, yeah.
You gotta, you gotta put that YDX Moro to good use.
I know,
you
know, right?
Yeah. So I guess there's a new trail up near Area 51 that's really good.
Oh, really?
Has Big Air Todd or Allers told you about it?
I have, no.
Yeah, it's supposed to be good.
Really?
But, yeah. No. We gotta go back to Area 51. We gotta get you with that new one.
Dude, those are some big jumps.
It's not that big.
Did it once. I think I'm good.
No, there's a bigger one.
Perfect. I need to jump any bigger.
So try a little bit of a relaxed day for you in the 450 class when it's out there is just in the sideline. So since you don't have an interest in the class, who you got for the win today?
I can just text you back. I'm on my way.
Well, I have an interest in the class. I mean, the 450 is still the most elite riders.
Hold on, I'm talking about like you don't have an entry.
Yeah, I don't have an entry.
Thank you.
I don't know. I mean, Jet's going really fast right now. It's gonna be wild for him just to pop up to the 450. I don't know if that's happened in a long time where you just straight out of the box and win an outdoor national in the 450 class. That'd be insane. But I think it'd be cool news. I just want the fans to be. I want it to be a good race and the fans are screaming. That's
yeah,
the most important part.
For sure. So how's Mosey? Is he 100%?
Yeah, I think he's good. Yeah, he's running real fast. I wish he could have qualified a little bit better, but we'll see.
Yeah, and then when are we going to get PV back?
Probably a couple weeks. Probably four more rounds, I think.
Yeah.
So that's why we have Caden in there to give him a shot at it. It's always good to give an up-and-coming kid a little boost here, see if he can turn some fast laps. It'll be awesome.
Yeah. You like having a national in your hometown? Home state, home area?
Yeah, I want to get back to Glen Helen.
Yeah.
Glen Helen's, you know, our Anaheim stadium, so did talk to Kerry Coombs this morning, and just, I mean, well, it's good, but I just think that, you know, Glen Helen is our Anaheim stadium.
It's a heritage.
Yeah.
I haven't seen your dad in a long time. What's up,
hey,
mate?
What's
how are you?
Good.
What are you filming?
You're wearing it. Huh? I did.
Yeah.
You're like hauling ass. You blew my hair forward and I had the windows rolled up. So what do you think of the guys wearing your shit?
I think it's cool.
Yeah?
It looks good.
I don't remember. Did they make red like that?
Yeah.
Oh, they did. Red or purple?
Yeah.
See, I think they should be in the purple personally.
Yeah.
I'm partial to the purple. Did you wear the red one too?
No.
Only purple, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. But no, it looks good.
Yeah. Who you got today? See the qualifying?
Yeah, fuck qualifying.
Jet's like a full second faster.
Yeah, I think he's probably going to win.
Yeah.
I mean, look.
Be good to see this guy on podium.
Yeah.
What up?
Santi.
What's happening?
P3, how's he feeling?
I think good, yeah. He likes overcast days, so.
Ah, yeah.
He's out there cruising around. He's actually surprised, you know, like, oh, okay, pretty good lap. Put a good time up, too, so I didn't feel like a burner, you know? So,
uh-huh.
Yeah, I think
your,
he's all right.
Your guy, he stands up in the corners a lot, huh?
Yeah, I noticed on press day, he doesn't put his feet out either.
Yeah.
It's a strategic move.
I was like, you know, like taking pictures of everyone in the same corner laid over. AC comes through standing up,
yeah,
but he's still super fast. Yeah, yeah. It takes too much effort to go up and down. How much taller is that
mil,
seat?
Yeah.
30 mil.
Yeah, but now I see a stock seat. Like I was cleaning out my cabinet, they look terrible now. they look like they're so shaved down.
Yeah.
That thing's so easy to put a cover on because it's flat.
Yeah. Dude, look at that thing.
You missed it. We went and rode Vale yesterday after I left.
Did you?
Yeah.
Straight from here to Vale?
Yeah.
I haven't been there yet.
Oh, it's awesome.
Did you do the jump line?
Yep. Big dogs.
Did you get them all?
Yeah.
I want to go check it out.
You've done some big shit, so.
Yeah, I know, but still.
This is no problem.
I want to go check it out. See, the whole Vale place is just bad, painful memories for me because that's where I race cross country.
Oh.
It's fucking horrible.
We went over on the cross country course and we're hitting a couple of jumps.
Yeah.
Huh? So. And then we found a little like BMX like track, and me and Zach were racing it.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, right off the gates and stuff.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you do like a turn, a jump, a turn, two more jumps, and a turn, and then you're racing yeah. the end on this tabletop.
Sick, sick. Right on. Hey, what's the biggest difference in that bike for outdoors from Supercross, besides suspension settings, obviously?
Right,
is there so a part that's different?
Linkage is a little bit different.
Uh-huh.
Like you said, obviously suspension, different clamps, different races.
Clamps, so offsets.
Offset. Carbon tank for more fuel. Yeah. Oil cooler.
Mm-hmm.
We run it through the radiator now.
Yeah.
Air boot.
Air boot's different. So more top end?
Yeah.
Hey, your pump, the carbon tank takes a regular gas cap.
I fought for that when I came here. They had a flush cap.
Yeah.
And you have to carry that stupid
tool right? Yeah.
But our flush cap had like this lip on it, so where when you open it, all the sand would get underneath there. So I pushed Aaron to get, I said, I gotta have a regular screw on cap. Yeah. So he's very accommodating. So
nice guy.
A year after I got Kranz on board, he's like, yeah, I hate this thing. stock cap it is.
Nice.
And the flush cap looks cool, but it's not that easy to work with having to have a special tool.
Yeah, you got enough stuff in your fanny pack.
Exactly.
Yeah. Do you wear a fanny pack when you mountain bike?
No, I don't like it. I barely can wear a camelback. I don't like anything on my back.
That's
you
no
jump,
good.
Like that whole you.
Yeah, it moves. No, I don't know. No.
Zach always rides with a camelback, and so did Kranz. Kranz always used a camelback.
Yeah.
So.
My best camelback story. I was at Sunrise Cycle Park.
Where was that at?
Racetown 395 up in Adelanto. Yeah. And I was riding a 125 Honda. It was like so slow. I was pissed. It was so slow. So I held it wide open in this turn. And all of a sudden it like decided to go fast for the first time in its whole existence. And I looped out. And I was dragging behind the bike, looping out, and there was a guy stopped on the infield of the track talking to his buddy, and he had a camelback on, and my front tire hit the camelback, and all I remember was like going, oh no, and then just being completely wet.
Oh, you exploded.
I popped the guy's camelback.
No way.
So I got him a new lever and a new camelback.
No way. I wear one when I go skiing underneath my jacket.
Yeah, but you got bourbon in it or something, right?
Yeah. Side pocket.
Hey Corey.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
It's a small community. You guys got to stick together.
Yeah, we do.
Don't put that in there.
So, how does it feel, dude? You're like living out this...
Marisa.
Huh?
Come here.
Missing a press conference.
Oh, really?
Is it going on?
It's past 6 o'clock.
Is it? All right, we'll do this real quick.
Why'd you call me right here?
It's 6:04. All right, ready?
Yeah.
All right, what was the question?
Dude, how does it feel, dude?
It feels good, man. Dude, I'm blown away once again. Like, I couldn't believe he's like did a podium first round of the series. And I know he did a few rounds last year, but that was just to get his feet wet, to be prepared for this season. You gotta understand, this is his rookie season. Like, rookie, 17. You know, he's still, still in school. Like, there's so many things that... are really surprising to us, but at the end of the day, he works his ass off. He's super dedicated to the sport and to his team to get better. Mm-hmm. He's a good team leader, and at the end, he just like really is showing us what his levels are. I think when he raced amateur, he raced fast enough just to win the races,
mm-hmm.
and there was a couple races he fell, and we kind of got to see a glimpse of like, whoa, there's another level, right?
Yeah.
And now here, he's bringing the other level. Mm-hmm. And there's only so good he can do with the experience he has. Mm-hmm. But man, he's racing against some good guys. You know, Hunter's guy is just really good. The Lawrence brothers, really good. They have a great program. Very hard to beat. But imagine if he wasn't in the game, the season hating would be happening. It's crazy.
Did he surprise you today?
Oh, he surprised me today in a way of how it surprised me getting a podium, yes. I figured he'd be somewhere around fifth at best. I said, Hayden, if you can break a top five, that's going to be a great day.
Yeah.
You know, especially coming from last year, you know? Because outdoors are gnarly. This is not East Coast Supercross, dude. This track is like so rough, yeah. And it scares me because he's like on the edge, just flying. I'm like, oh, I'm so worried about him crashing. That the speeds are so high, and once he gets comfortable in to running in the top three, he's the type of kid that hates losing.
Yeah.
So once he gets comfortable, I think he'll be expect to be there every time. But yeah, I always wonder. I'm like, how am I gonna feel at the end of the day today? Like starting the day.
Hey, you know what I just thought of? Kids beat you.
Who's that?
He's beat you now. He hasn't won a Supercross yet.
He hasn't won a Supercross, but he's done. I didn't ever have podium outdoor. Yeah. No way. But yeah, he's gonna blow by all. Hopefully, like everything I've accomplished. As a parent, you want your kids to be better than you ever were. You know, that's your goal as a parent. Is hopefully they don't make all the mistakes we made. You know, live in the 90s and all the crazy days. But he's much more responsible, and he's got his mindset on one goal. You know, he wants to be the best, and it's gonna take time. And this team's a great, been awesome support for us. And we couldn't be at a better spot. And we try to position ourselves. We played all the chess pieces to be in this position, right? Mm-hmm. And we're just getting started. And like I said, it's just exciting as parents. Yeah. It's just an exciting time. You know, and did I expect to be here today in this position? No. Did I think he was going to get second today? No. Yeah. But now I'm like, oh, okay. Here we go. Here we're in the fight. So anyway, we're just having fun and making memories. So it's good.
Congrats, man.
Thank you.
Spherical. We're giving away one a month to the best crash video submission that we get. Send your entries to swap@swapmotolive.com. Good luck.